Wonder if I can match that pumpkin's face. Not bad, not bad. Hello, welcome back to my channel. My name is Sam Scott-Thorne and I am a vocal coach based in Glasgow. Now, if you'd like to meet and explore your voice a little more, you can find me on sstvocals.com. You can also find me on various other social media platforms and I'll put my handles down below and over there. Over there. What? I don't know what that was, but it's fine. Let's just keep going. Now, if you'd like to consider becoming a patron, you have access to things like early release of reactions, you can fast track reactions, become a reaction, there's special roles on my Discord server, and you have access to all sorts of bonus content like outtakes and my Vocal Anatomy 101 series where you get to learn about vocals. So consider becoming a patron and help shape my channel. Okay, we are going to listen to SHINee. I think that's how you say it. I don't think I've listened to SHINee before. So if you're coming here because you're a fan of SHINee, this is not just a regular reaction. I mean, I don't look like this all the time. We're in Halloween week and this has been suggested as a spooky music video to watch. I believe they're a South Korean boy band. I might be wrong, but I've not listened to them. I've not seen the video. Let's just go and see what we think of Married to the Music.
Yeah. Wait up, girl, hold on.
So listen, baby. High and high is high, got in laces, got beauty for later.
Ooh, I like that one.
Hey, 네 어깨 위 아수 see through.
Oh, I like his voice. That is a really, really nice riff. Very kind of easy as well to do. Da 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 da. But it takes you in a place. It just does something to me. His voice has got this lovely kind of aspirate quality to it. So there's more air coming through the folds than normal and you get a kind of a breathier sound. But then he's pushing that, hey sexy lady. So you get this kind of exasperated sound off of it. It's really, really nice. Very textured. Digging it. Oh, I am loving the harmonies here. They are very, very tight. Lovely vocal outfit. That guy's voice there was quite conversational, so mid-place larynx, nothing too crazy in either direction, so he actually has quite a good voice for just carrying the song. The video was doing something, so I couldn't tell whether he did the higher part in that kind of falsetto-y sound, so I might just have to see if I can catch that later on. This is why I like live stuff, so I can see what's going on, but I'm enjoying the video too, and I love that bass line. I am a sucker for a good bass line, and that is a good bass line.
I'm married to the music.
Okay, I like this song. That didn't go in the direction I thought it was going to go to. A lot of K-pop stuff does this. It kind of makes me feel like it's going to go in one direction and then the chorus just flips itself on its head. I really enjoyed that. I like the layered up thing that was going on. It just gives that kind of push and development and dynamic to the sound. They really do work well together. Obviously I'd have to hear them live, but like just in a recording situation, their voices all really work well together. Whoever was doing that high head voice place was really nice. It was quite light, but it wasn't falsetto. Now, falsetto is where your vocal folds, they kind of do this and they have a gap at the back so that the airflow is always coming through and they're held tight. Head voice is where your vocal folds stretch out, but they're still vibrating like they would if they were in thick. They're just vibrating on one level rather than two. I hope that makes sense. If you need further breakdown of that, it's on my Patreon. But his head voice was lovely, light, kind of pure. Vocal folds retracted, so you're getting a nice clean sound. Very impressed. Lovely. This song is good in the way that it kind of mixes that speechy sound, so it's got that kind of hype quality to it with singing. So it kind of almost goes like line for line. There's somebody in the background going, yeah, yeah, I agree, or whatever. I don't know what they're saying. So there's just like this kind of little element of that hype man feel to it, vibe, if you like. This guy here, a little bit more of a belted place. Da, 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 bop. So you're getting a little bit more projection out of that. There's possibly a little bit of rocking of his cricoid cartilage, which is letting more air get up behind the folds, so you've got a bigger push and like more of a blast through the folds, if you like, so it's a louder sound, probably anchoring there as well. Again, I'd need to see him doing it live, but it's a lovely sound to hear in a recording anyway. It's just got a little bit more bite to it. Grand. Let's keep going. So I think they are different people. That na 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 is probably more of a falsetto-y place. There's a couple of things that you can do to see if it's falsetto. If I was working with him, could he get louder? If you can't, it's probably falsetto because your folds are being held apart, and in order to get louder you need to get thicker, and you can't when they're held like that. The other thing would be, can he take it down his range, because it's quite hard to do falsetto down there. Just turns into air. So that to me is falsetto, but I could be wrong. I'd need to work with him. You're getting a dynamic off of this sound as well because of larynx height. So in a mid position, your larynx is kind of as it would be with speech. Da 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 da. You're not having to put too much effort in any direction, really. Then there's also that da 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 ba ba da, which is a higher larynx. So you're getting that brightness of sound. And then there is a couple in there going ba ba da ba 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 da, which is lowering that larynx. It gives you a smokier, darker texture. So they are really covering each bass. I don't know who's working with these guys in their vocals, but you're doing a fantastic job. that is top tier. They've thought of everything to balance that sound out. And it's just perfection. Even that little chant bit before the chorus, they had layers of different speech qualities. So you're just getting this complete cacophony of tones. It's lovely. That little harmony with those two high voices, da, da, those two tones together, Oh, it was amazing. It sounded like a kettle was ready to be used in tea. I enjoyed that sound very much. I don't know why I had to stop there, but that really got me. That was a nice harmony. They were both blending their voices through that with a little bit more of an aspirate quality, so a little bit more air. And that just gives it this kind of column of air for which these two tones can swim between, if that makes sense. They are very, very good vocalists. That was really good. That was really good. I enjoyed that. K-pop just has this thing of like getting you to move. It just brings the party. And I want to party. If they ever need a big pumpkin guy in their next video, they know where to look. Don't look. That's fine. Yeah, that was good. That was really fun. If there's live examples of them singing, send them over and we can go and take a wee listen. And I can maybe start to break down them more individually. That was an experience. I was mainly just watching the music video, to be honest. But I hope you liked that reaction. If you did, please give it a like and a thumbs up down below. And if you want to see more from me, hit subscribe, ring the bell, and anytime I have new content, you will be the first to know. So I guess all that's left for me to say is thank you so much for joining me, and how are we going to buy this one? Thanks so much for watching, but make sure that you like and subscribe. So thanks so much for watching. Thank you so much. I said it twice. And whatever. Bye.